The selection of a site for a nursery should be made with considerable care and thought, because location will have a major effect on the overall success of the organization. Soil, water, availability of labor, access to good roads, and the environment are factors of paramount importance in the selection of a site for a production nursery. Each factor should be considered and evaluated for the effect it will have on the overall success of the business. I'm Dr. DeBus, and this video discusses the ecological, economic, sociological, and biological factors that affect nursery site selection. For the production of nursery stocks, either field-grown or container-grown, a mild climate with a long growing season and even distribution of rainfall is most desirable. The land should be relatively level for efficient nursery operation. Steep slopes should be avoided, but rolling land can be terraced. The media for container-grown plants are generally artificially blended, therefore the native soil is not an important site factor for a container production nursery. For field production, bare root plants and seedlings can be produced best on sandy or sandy loam soil, while bald and burlap plants are best produced on either a silty loam or a clay loam soil. Soils with a granular or crumb structure make excellent soil for field production nurseries since they have good drainage while maintaining adequate moisture. The optimum soil reaction, pH, for the production of most woody plants is between 5.0 and 7.2. Soils for field production nurseries should contain 2 to 5% organic matter and must be free of pests including noxious weeds, nematodes, harmful insects, disease organisms, and herbicide residue which might restrict the growth or impair the quality of nursery crops. An ideal nursery site with respect to water would be one where there is good rainfall distribution throughout the planting and growing season with a minimum of rain or snow during the digging and shipping season. Since this is almost impossible to find, it is best to locate on a site where there is access to a dependable supply of quality water. Water can be obtained either through a municipal water system or from streams, rivers, ponds, lakes, or wells. It should be free of alkalinity, excessive salts, or industrial waste that might be detrimental to plant growth. Air pollution is a problem to be considered in selecting a site for a nursery. Air that is polluted with sulfur dioxide, fluorides, ozone, and photochemical smog should be avoided. Because soil, water, and air pollution have become problems in the production of nursery crops, in some areas it may be desirable to obtain an environmental audit of the soil and water resources prior to the transfer of agricultural property from a seller to a buyer. The audit serves as an assurance to the buyer that the soil is free of pollutants as claimed by the seller. The initial cost of the land will often be a determining factor in the decision to purchase it for a nursery establishment. Generally, it is thought that a large production nursery cannot afford to produce plants on high-priced land. On the other hand, nurseries engaged in intensive production, landscape nurseries or garden centers, can afford higher-priced land provided that all other factors do not limit productivity or sales. Many fine nurseries start on low-priced land, have closed or relocated as a result of increasing taxes caused by increased land values brought about by urbanization and reduced availability of subsurface water. One solution to high land costs is for an individual to own the land and lease it to the nursery on a long-term lease. This allows an individual to capitalize on appreciation of land values but permits a nursery to program production. In some states, tax advantages can be obtained if the land is committed by contract to long-term, at least 10 years, of agriculture. Because nurseries rely on considerable hand labor to perform much of the work associated with production and landscape construction, a supply of manual labor must be available. Because of the seasonal nature of nursery operations, demand for labor fluctuates dramatically. This seasonal need for unskilled labor is met in part by the employment of temporary laborers, some of which may not be U.S. citizens. However, with the passage of labor laws, many nurseries are finding it difficult to obtain seasonal labor. Some have solved this problem by employing high school students, off-duty firemen, retirees, homemakers, and so on a part-time basis, whereas others are contracting for the employment of laborers from the various territories of the United States. Still, other growers are either contracting out some of the production operation, for example, digging and packaging, or they are mechanizing many of the traditional hand operations associated with the nursery industry. In addition to manual laborers, nurseries also need increasing numbers of individuals capable of performing various skilled operations, for example, propagators, integrated pest managers, etc. and others who have abilities as supervisors or managers. All nurseries require power. Some need only one form, while others may require many forms. Electric power is needed for lighting and the operation of equipment, including irrigation pumps, refrigerators, potting machines, computers, and so on. Three-phase electric power is desirable to operate larger types of machines. Oil, gas, or coal is necessary for the operation of the heating plant. Gasoline is needed in large quantities to power trucks, tractors, cars, and other equipment used in the nursery. Good transportation facilities are necessary for most nurseries. A high percentage of the nursery stock shipped in the U.S. is transported by truck. A garden center located on a road or highway that affords easy access is much more desirable than one located on a superhighway or on a second-class or unpaved road where access is difficult. Competition should always be evaluated before starting a new business. This is particularly true when the establishment will serve a clientele in a limited geographic area. The number of similar establishments and the progressiveness of each should be carefully considered. An elementary question that should be answered prior to starting a new business is, what service or product can I offer at a profitable price that will satisfy consumer needs that is not currently being offered by other competing nurseries? However, competition is not a problem in selecting a site for a production nursery that will have a large market area, for example, many states or the nation. In fact, the presence of other nurseries in the area may be an asset. Growers often cooperate with each other on the use of specialized equipment, human resources, and in shipping arrangements. Many sociological factors have influenced and will continue to influence the development of the nursery just as they influence many other segments of the economy. Increased population, wealth, and leisure time all point to a greater demand for nursery products. These factors may vary considerably between communities. The mode of life and the background of the people may also influence the acceptance of the products and services to be offered or the manner by which they can be merchandised. City or township clerk should be contacted relative to zoning restrictions, building codes, permits, and business licenses prior to buying land to develop a nursery or prior to improving the present facilities. The availability and quantity of the schools, churches, hospitals, civic associations, and cultural centers are also important considerations for all segments of the nursery industry. Various biological factors should also be investigated prior to selecting a site for a nursery, including the presence of any serious insect, disease, or weed pests. In addition, in some parts of the country, deer can be a serious pest, causing extensive damage to nursery stock. County agricultural or horticultural extension agents can often provide information on the presence and seriousness of these pests in their counties. Extension specialists located at land-grant universities can provide information on the control and eradication of pests. The Department of Natural Resources or a related agency can provide information on deer populations, including seasonal patterns, deer management programs, fence construction, and advice on site selection. In conclusion, establishing a successful nursery, landscape operation, or garden center is not a simple matter. Therefore, prior to selecting the site, all factors should be considered and evaluated.